Hello everybody, my name is Michael Knoll. I'm coming to you from Holiday World in League City. I want to tell you guys a little bit about our brand new 2015. First thing you're going to notice is a handsome rig. It's got a nice chocolate brown color, and one of the biggest characteristics of this vehicle is its towing capabilities. What I mean by that is it's extremely light. It can be towed by any half-ton truck. It's got a 50-degree nose. There's only a few in the industry that has a 50-degree nose. That's one of the big things about this. With a fiberglass cap and a completely closed underbelly, it's going to save a lot of money in your fuel costs and be very, very easy on your truck as well. This right here is where you're going to keep your propane, where you have an easy access lid. You can get to your tanks. It's got a self-adjusting lever in here to where it's going to switch the propane from one tank to the other. We've got a handy dandy little electric tongue jack right here with the light on in case you come to or leave your RV site at dawn or dusk. This is going to come in handy as well. We got a rack down here for two batteries. Of course, we're always going to give you a marine grade battery. I would suggest two. Right here, we've got 12-point LED docking station lights, also to assist you at dusk or dawn type conditions. The roof is made out of a one-piece EPDM style roof. There's absolutely no seams in this roof. It also incorporates galvanized steel trusses with hurricane straps. A couple additional features of this rig is it's an all aluminum cage construction. Now on top of the I-beam, there's an aluminum framework for the high density foam application. The foam and the lamination process is the same on the floor as it is on the walls. It's very, very strong because it comes in layers and it just makes for a very strong product. You got 40 cubic feet of storage space that is the most in the industry for this type of rig. If you look inside here, you'll notice the weld work inside here. A lot of these rigs here where they claim that they're aluminum, one, there's hardly any aluminum in them, or they're screwed together or they're tack welded. All of our aluminum is welded completely top to bottom, both sides. It's a very rough and sturdy little rig. You come with me this way, you'll notice that we've got three steps here. And we've got traction device already cut into the steps themselves. This ain't just the tape on here, which I've slipped and busted my butt many times on my own rig. You got an extra long grab bar handle here. I think comes in very, very handy on this rig. These are the new 2015 style windows. These windows have three really great features. One is you can leave them all the way open in a torrential downpour. You're not gonna get any rain inside your rig. The gaskets are never exposed to sunlight. And it's 80% tinted. Your fabrics aren't going to fade, your carpet's not going to fade, and it's also going to keep the heat load down on your rig as well. If you walk with me this way, you'll notice the tires right here. The tires, it looks like there's nothing special about them, but there are. What they are is they're aluminum, they're very attractive. Aluminum tires always stay more true than steel rim tires. These right here at 43-inch centers. You know, some of the rigs, they're real close together. What this is going to do, this is going to make the rig track very, very well behind your tow vehicle. It's also going to take some of the tongue weight off of your vehicle, and you really need to be nice to your vehicle when you start towing these things. You never want to overstress your truck or your car or what have you. You follow me down this way, everybody needs a little camp stove. We got an entire kitchen right here. We got a two-burner propane stove. We got a tiny little micro fridge right here for your extra beverages. You don't want to go inside on a pretty day and start having to cook and while everybody else is out having fun. So this is going to eliminate all that. You've got a hot and cold water running sink right here and gas struts to help you lift the door. Now it's kind of a windy day now, so I'm not going to show you the awning, but it's a nice, very nice, attractive black and chocolate and white awning. A pretty neat feature is the fact that it's got pocket doors. Now most of your RV is going to have storage to the left and to the right of the bed, which this one also does, but it's got residential light fixtures above the bed, which gives it a more homey look. One of the things about a Bullet Premier is the fact that they just enhance the success of the standard Bullet. They made it more of a home-like camper instead of just a camping experience. You got more of a living experience. So you've got the pocket doors here. If you look inside, you'll notice that it's got puck lighting above the bed, and it's also got reading lights above the bed. This right here is a neat feature. All Bullet Premiers, all Bullets, period, have this. This is called a laundry chute. In rigs this small, space is optimal. So what we do is we try to keep everything off the floor for you. This right here is a laundry chute, so you don't have to have a laundry hamper and just leave your clothes anywhere. That being noted, this right here, you have a designated space for your trash can. I don't know how many times people will buy a unit, such as myself, having made mistakes on my units in the past, and there's no place to put a trash can, there's no place to put your dirty clothes, there's no place to put your groceries. So Bullet Premier is addressed to all those things in a pretty opulent way. If you get stuck in bad weather, and you're not going to mind spending some time with your family inside the Bullet Premier. You've got a two sink system here. Also, you have a sprayer nozzle that comes out, which is going to be really convenient for your larger pots and pans and whatnots. Some of the standard features, which comes with pretty much every travel trailer. However, this right here, this vent right here over the stove, this ain't one of those vents that just blows the funk back in your face. This is actually going to go outside. It's going to take the greasy, warm air, it's going to blow it outside of your coach, so you don't have to condition the space or nothing like that. This is called a Helium Atwood refrigerator. Looks like there's nothing special to it. However, there are a couple neat features. One, the thing gets down to 16 degrees in the freezer and down to 42 degrees in the cab, and that's in a 12-hour period. As everybody knows, you plug in your refrigerator, it takes at least 24 hours for it to get cold. That's a feature of this rig. Of course, it runs on electric and propane, and it also has replaced the molecule with helium. That's what makes it cold so quickly. You can also be at a steep incline as you're traveling and not wreak havoc on your refrigerator. You don't have the push-pull button, which is kind of silly on a refrigerator. You just grab it. You'll notice here, I left my iced tea first of all here. You'll notice that it's got an LED light in here that makes it nice, soothing light, and it's tucked away. You notice in some of the other units, you're going to have a big light stuck right to the side so it can get scraped off as soon as you put your gallon of milk in there. So there's a whole bunch of neat features with this refrigerator simply but by not just getting your stuff cold. This right here is the bathroom. There's really not much space for both of us to be in here, but we're going to try. It's got a really big shower space. It's got a three-tier door system. It does have opaque glass for your privacy. It right above the outside kitchen area that I showed you, all that space has not been wasted. There's a bunch of linen space above the toilet here that's incorporated. So all of your towels or your bigger stuff, there's no mullions in the middle to get in the way of putting all your big gear here. You've got a real wood medicine chest. This isn't one of those hokey plastic medicine chests. It's very nice looking, it's very eye appealing, and you've got a nice vanity area here. A nice little shelf system right here. Again, this is all about feeling at home when you're not. And Bullet Premier has done all that. Another thing that Bullet Premier has done is given you a place to put your groceries. How many times have you found that you borrowed a buddy's camper or even purchased your own camper and you're putting canned goods wherever you can find to put canned goods? Every single Bullet Premier has a place, a pantry to put your stuff. And this is a large pantry for a 22-foot unit, believe me. You don't have to resort to putting it in any cabinet above or even above your bed, which I have seen done. This is your table area. It's going to eat four. It also turns into a bed. It's a 74-inch bed. A lot of the traders out there you're going to see, it's just confined to either smaller people or quite literally children. But this is a 74-inch wide place to sleep. And I'm 72 inches tall, so even I could sleep there. So I think that's a nice feature. You got residential style light fixtures right here and puck lighting throughout. The puck lighting lasts a long time. They're LED lights. What the rounded ceiling does for you, it insulates your coach better. You've got 5 inches of insulation that goes all the way across the top. And I think I have mentioned before that it's got galvanized steel stamp trusses with hurricane straps in between those. The galvanized is 200% stronger than aluminum, so that's why they choose it to put on the roof, which is pretty much the most vulnerable part of your RV. Right here above the sink, you have got some storage area. And I want to mention, if I had not before, there is no mullion in between here, so you can put your larger pots and pans in here. There is no shelf in between either, so you want to just put little narrow items. Right down here, you have a couple drawers. I want to notice that they're full extension, and this is not particle board. This is actually plywood, and these things are hold a capacity of 60 pounds apiece. I'm pulling this little tool out because I think this is the neatest thing since sliced bread. Let's say you're at an RV place and the power goes out for some reason whatsoever. You should always be carrying a cordless drill with you whenever you camp, period. There are certain things you just must have, and that's one of them. What you're going to do, let's say you have no power at all, there's a mechanism right behind this fascia. You're going to take this, hook it up to your drill, put it on here, and you're literally going to slide in, back in. Your boss is not going to be too sympathetic to you if you don't show up to work on Monday morning and tell him it's because you can't get your slide in. So, you know, I think this is a pretty nifty little thing. As far as entertainment, you've got a flat screen TV, which does have a articulating arm on it, which you could pull out and move to the left and to the right. You've got a high definition TV. You've also got a stereo here that has got a USB port. It's Bluetooth compatible, and you can zone the speakers out, inside, outside, front, back, and things, they really do rock it out. So if you want to have fun with your family and your friends, then this is the rig to do it in. It's small, it's light, it's built like a tank, it's attractive, and it's going to be around for a very long time, and we're just really proud to have them here at Holiday World. If you guys should need more information, just ask for Michael Knoll, and I'll be glad to chat it up with you and bring you out here myself and show you some of these neat features we just talked about. Have a nice day.